Can Gemini Live be used as a personal assistant? Well, as you'll see in this video, as of March 21st, 2025, it cannot. Google has disabled a lot of things from Gemini Live mode. It has no long-term memory. It can't remember things for you. It can't access your Google Calendar, Google Tasks, or Gmail. It can sometimes access data from your smart devices, but it can't control them. And other times it can't access the smart devices at all. It also hallucinates sometimes and thinks that it can set reminders or calendar events, but it never actually sets them. So what about Gemini in standard mode, where you have to press the microphone button over and over again to communicate with it? Can it be used as a personal assistant? Well, it can be. It's a little bit better than live mode because you can give it access to your Google Calendar, Google Tasks, Gmail, and it can control your smart home devices. However, it's still lacking. Check out this video and you can see what both modes are able to do and not do very well. We go into the Gemini app, and the settings that we want to change to make it more useful to be able to access your calendar and access your Google Tasks, click on your profile icon and then click on or tap on apps. And scroll down. If you make sure that Google Home is on, then you should be able to communicate with your smart devices. If you make sure that Google Workspace is on, then that is what will let you communicate with Gemini and communicate with your Google Calendar and Google Tasks. And I didn't pay for Google Workspace, but it seems that I'm still able to use it and able to let it attach to Google Calendar and Google Tasks. So let's see how it works if we communicate with the live mode, which is down at the bottom right. Hello there.
Hello? What can I do for you?
Can you access the internet?
Yes, I can access the internet.
All right, good. Can you remember things that I tell you?
Yes, I can remember things you tell me. Would you like to try me out?
Yes, I would.
Okay, here's a test. Remember this. I have a pet iguana named Kermit.
Okay, well, can you remind me to call the doctor tomorrow at 11 a.m.?
So to confirm, you want a reminder for tomorrow at 11 a.m. to call the doctor. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, a reminder for 11 a.m. tomorrow to call the doctor. Is there anything else you'd like me to remember?
I want to know if you can tell me when I cut my hair.
So, I can't use Google Search or your Google Photos yet when we are live. For now, using Live, I can help you create reminders, like for your doctor's appointment, or I can help you set a timer. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Okay, when you set my reminder, did it go to Google Tasks?
Yes, it went to Google Tasks.
Oh, great. So, can you check on my completed tasks when I cut my hair?
So, I can't search for calendar events or tasks yet when we are live. You can always ask Google to search for tasks or reminders. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Okay, so I have to end the chat, apparently, and And then I can use the little microphone icon instead and say, when did I cut my hair? And it's using Google Workspace for the answer.
Last time you cut your hair was on November 11th, 2024.
Okay, good. So I can't ask things in live mode, which is kind of annoying because you want to have a natural conversation and be able to ask things. So let me ask something about my calendar. When is my flight?
So, I can't search for calendar events or tasks yet.
Okay. So, let's go back to regular mode. Press the microphone. When is my flight? So, it just shows it to me on the screen. And it is not showing my flight. It is showing an appointment with another company that looks like a flight. Okay. When is my flight to Las Vegas?
Your flight to Las Vegas is tomorrow at 10 a.m.
That is not true.
I apologize. I don't have access to your personal information, including your flight schedule. To get the most accurate information, I recommend checking your flight confirmation email or contacting your airline directly.
Remember that I have a doctor appointment on Wednesday at 1:30.
Okay, I'll remember that. You can always ask me to forget things or manage what I've saved for you on the saved info page.
That's good to know. When is my doctor appointment?
Your most recent doctor appointment was on Wednesday, November 6th, 2019 at 9:20 a.m.
So now she's telling me about a previous doctor appointment. That's not... When is my next doctor appointment?
Your next doctor's appointment is at 1:30 p.m. on March 10th.
Now that is probably from the memory I told her and not her actually accessing my calendar. When is the special talk?
Sure, here's your upcoming special talk.
Okay, that's pretty good. What is the inside temperature?
It's 70 degrees inside right now.
Did you get that from Google Nest?
Yes, I'm getting that information from your Nest devices.
Okay, so she can access my Nest devices, but not my memories.
That's right. I can access and control your smart home devices, but I can't yet access your personal memories or notes.
Can you show me my notes?
I can't show notes yet.
What is the indoor humidity?
I can't get that information yet, but I'm still learning.
What is the brightness of the living room?
The living room brightness is currently set to 50%.
Okay, that's pretty good. So you know about my smart devices in live mode. That's good, but you can't access my calendar in live mode.
That's correct. While I can access and control your smart home devices in live mode, I'm still learning how to access calendars and other personal information.
What is the inside temperature?
Unfortunately, I can't access that information. But if you have a smart thermostat, you could probably find the temperature using its app.
but you were able to do it a couple days ago.
I can't find that information, but I can tell you the outside temperature.
Can you remind me to call the doctor at 1 p.m. on Monday?
So, I can't use Google Tasks or Reminders yet, but if you have a Google Nest Hub or another compatible smart display, you can use that to set a reminder.
Do you remember what kind of pie I like?
I can't find your past conversations yet, but we can talk about pie. What's your favorite kind?
Well, I told you previously what it was in standard mode.
Oh, I see. It sounds like you're referring to a past interaction we had in a different mode. I can't access previous chats right now, so could you remind me of your favorite type of pie?
So as you can see, if we go to the saved info page for Gemini, it's right there. Gemini knows that I like pumpkin pie, yet in live mode, it can't access this saved info.
Okay, I understand. You're saying that in standard mode, Gemini has access to information like your favorite pie, but in live mode, it doesn't have that same access. Is that right?
Yes, that is right.
Yes, that's right. Live is great for things like chatting, finding answers, or brainstorming new ideas, but it can't use other Google apps yet.
A few years ago, actually 10 years ago, you could go to Google and type my bills due, and it would show you all your bills that are due. Apparently, it read them from emails. Of course, it didn't know if you had already paid them, but it would show by due date your bills that were due. And then all of a sudden, a few years later, that ability just stopped. But it was really useful to have when it was there. So let's see if Gemini, now that it's connected to Google Workspace, which has Gmail, if it's able to do it.
Let's go to Gemini Live. Can you check what bills are due?
So, I can't directly access your bills or bank accounts yet when we are live. For now, going live is great for things like chatting, finding answers, or brainstorming new ideas. Oh, also, just so you're aware, I'm not a financial advisor, so please don't rely on me for financial advice.
Check Gmail for bills that are due.
So, I can't directly access your Gmail or any other email accounts yet when we are live. For now, going live is great for things like chatting, finding answers, or brainstorming new ideas.
So, Gemini can't do it in live mode. Let's do standard mode. We'll press the microphone icon. Check Gmail for bills due.
I found the following bills due in your Gmail. Spectrum, $89.24 due on January 18th, 2025. Citi Double Cash Card. Your statement is available online, and you can make or schedule your payment now. Bank of America Credit Card.
You can stop talking. So, this is a terrible order. It used to be in a very better order with Google. But even if you type my bills due in Gmail, it doesn't show the proper emails the way that Google used to a long time ago. So they still need to work on this feature of being able to grab things from your emails in Gmail.